Welcome to the learning portal of Thakur Vidya Mandir High School and Junior College. Welcome to the learning portal of Thakur Vidya Mandir High School and Junior College. Hello students, we are here again with the new video of HTML topic. In last video class, we have learned about the introduction of HTML along with its feature, advantages and disadvantages. Today, we'll move on to define or to the structure and what are the different tags which define the document of your HTML. So, today's class will cover the following topic, structure tags of HTML. Which are the physical or formatting tags which support HTML, heading tag and marquee tag. The essential and basic tags of HTML code are HTML, head, title and body. Let's look at each tag in detail. HTML. In order for the browser to open the HTML file, it must be told that the file is an hypertext markup file. This can be done by making the beginning of the file with HTML tag and end of the file with slash HTML tag. All other tag resides in between HTML and the ending HTML tag. The second part of a structure is head tag. Head tag defines the header area of the page, which is not displayed within the page itself. So whatever you place inside the head tag will not be visible to you on the document. The end of the head tag ends the header area of the page. The third is title tag. The text between start title and end title is the title of the web page and is displayed in the title bar of the browser. The title should be descriptive as it is frequently used by web indexing and searching program to name your web page. There should not be extra space between title tag and the text of the title. Title tag is part of your head tag, so it is placed within the header section. So whatever you write in the title tag will not be visible in the document. It will be visible only on the title bar of the page. The next structural tag is body tag. The actual content of the web page that will be displayed on the browser will appear in the body section of document. The body section starts with body tag and ends with slash body tag, that is the ending tag. There are several optional attributes for this tag, such as background image. Change the font of the text by using the attributes. The body section defines the actual instruction for laying out graphics, text, multimedia, and other elements in the browser's work area. Some of the attributes of body tag are BG color. BG color stands for background color. It specifies the color to be used for the background. So you can set the background color as I told in the previous PPTs that if I want to set the attribute, I have to write the name of the attribute followed by equal to symbol and then the value. So if I assign BG color equal to red or BG color equal to blue or black, the background of the document will display in that particular color. You can also set the color code for the same. Next is text attribute. Text attribute defines the color for the text. So it is foreground color. And the last one is the background attribute. This attribute specifies an image file which will be used on the background. It is important to make an image file as small as possible because if you use a large file as a background, your page will appear to be very slow to download. Structure. As we can see, we have learned about the structural tags. Now, how to define those structural tags with HTML? You first write HTML followed by head tag. As I told, that title tag is part of your head section, so it is enclosed in between head tag. So title, whatever is the title, for example, if I want to give title as home page or the index page, so I can write the title in between where in between title and title tag. Then I will close the head section. As for now, according to your portion, there is only title tag which will come in between head section. And then we start with the body, that is the actual framing of the document of your web page. So body tag followed by whatever is the content. So when we will be learning about different tags in ahead, we'll place all those tags in between body and the closing body tag. And once you finish the framing of your body tag, you will go for the HTML closing. Moving on to the next topic, that is physical tag. Physical tag can also be named as formatting tag. What is formatting tag? The features which are present on the format bar of your Windows document is formatting tag. Now, there are various formatting tags, and these tags or physical tags are always placed in between body tag. We'll start with the first tag of physical tag section, that is B tag. B is a bold tag. The text appearing between start tag and the end tag will be displayed in bold letters. The next is I tag. I is an italic tag. The text appearing between start tag and the end tag will be displayed in italic. The next one is U tag. U is underlined tag. The text appearing between starting U tag and the end U tag will be underlined. Generally, browser indicates hyperlink in web page by underlining them, so it is generally avoided. The next tag is SUP tag. SUP stands for superscript. The text enclosed between the opening SUP and the closing SUP tag will appear in a superscript manner. So if I want to display any mathematical formula like x square or y square, so then the square value will be written inside superscript. Then you have subscript. Subscript is given by SUB tag. So whatever you write in between SUP and the closing SUB tag will appear little below the original text. So if I say H2O, so 2 is a subscript of H, so it will go below. The next physical tag is P tag. It is used for creating a paragraph of text. A paragraph created by enclosing text between the opening and the closing P tag will be displayed in a paragraph format. The browser ignores the paragraph created by user while writing quotes by pressing the enter. User must specifically define a paragraph in the code by using a paragraph tag. The P tag has an optional attribute called align, where the value for align will be left, right, center, or justify. The next physical tag is EM tag. EM tag is equivalent to your I tag. So as I tag gives you a italic format, even EM tag will display the font in italic. The only difference between EM tag and I tag is when it comes to text-to-speech browser, EM tags put an emphasis on the word or text while speaking. Next is strong tag. Again, strong tag is equivalent to B tag. So whatever text is placed between strong and a closing strong tag will appear in bold character. But again, the same differences that in text-to-speech browser, strong tag will put a strident effect on the text while speaking. Next tag is B tag. B tag makes the text one size bigger than the usual text. So if I have a data displayed on the web page, and if I put anything between B tag, the data inside B tag will be plus one size bigger. Same way, small tag will make the character one size smaller than the usual text. Then you have pre tag, which we call it as a pre-formatting tag. So it is used to pre-format the text. Basically, the text appearing between start and the closing start will be displayed in a monospace format. This tag is used to position the character. The tag displays the text in exactly same format as the character and line spacing format defined in the source of HTML document, that is in the notepad. The next is strike tag. Strike tag puts a strip on the text when it is displayed on the browser. Let's move on with more physical tags. Next tag is HR tag. HR tag is a horizontal rule tag, which is also called as horizontal line tag. A web page can be divided into separate section by using horizontal rule tag. This tag is mostly used for decorative purpose and it is an individual tag, so it is not followed by any data, so there won't be any closing HR section like slash HR. It is a standalone tag. There are various attributes of HR tag like color, size, width and no resize. Color defines the color of your line. Size will define how thick you want the rule to appear on the page. Width decides the length of the rule, whereas no resize is used to define an actual layout of your horizontal rule. Next is BR tag. BR tag is used as break line. It inserts a line break and follows a text into a new line. It tells the browser to wrap the text that follows onto a new line without inserting any extra space between the lines. For the entire blank line, BR tag can be inserted. For multiple blank line, you can increase the count of the BR tag, so it will go on printing a blank line. Again, BR is a standalone tag. It does not have a closing tag. The next category of tag is heading tag. Heading tag is mentioned as HN, followed by the document or the text, and closing HN, where N value can be 1 to 6. So H1 to H6. There are different heading in the 6 levels, where H1 is a highest level heading. So whatever you write in between H1 and closing H1 tag will appear with the bold as well as biggest size. Whereas when you write in H6, it will be the lowest size with the bold character. There is only one attribute with HN, that is the color attribute. So whatever color you want to set for the heading, that will appear in HN. The next is marquee tag. The text enclosed between marquee and a closing marquee will scroll on the screen from right to left. The text written between the start tag and the end tag of Marquee will scroll on the screen on a horizontal line. There are several attributes associated with Marquee tag, such as BG color, height, width, direction, and behavior. BG color defines the background color for the Marquee section. If you have seen a television screen in news, there is a news scrolling down. So such kind of effect can be created with Marquee tag. Also, you can define a different color background for different Marquee. If you have more than Marquee, you can define a BG color, separate background color for each Marquee. You can define how much height is required in the document to display the Marquee. Then you have direction. Direction specify from where you want to start. By default, as I said, that the text will scroll from right to left. So if I define direction equal to left, it will start from right and go towards left. Same way, if I define direction equal to right, it will start from left and go towards right. Next is behavior. Behavior defines what kind of scrolling you need. There are three values for behavior. First is scroll, second one is alternate, and third one is slide. Scroll gives you a plain movement of the text, where the scroll will start from right side, it will go towards left, and again then it will start from right. Alternate is wherein it will start from right, go towards left of the screen, it will stop towards the left part of the screen, and again bounce back towards the right screen. The next is slide. Slide, where the text will start from right hand side and it will go towards left and stop there. So it will be only one time scrolling. There is also a width attribute which defines that what is the breadth required for the Marquee area. Before we sign off for today's class, let's focus on the board question for today's topic. What are structural tags in HTML? Give the structure of HTML web page. What are essential or basic tags of HTML code? Explain the purpose of the following tag: HTML, head, title, body. What are the different attributes of the body tag in HTML? Explain the following tags in HTML which are listed below. Thank you. Love and peace from TVM family.